Hello everyone, welcome to this new video in our series Coding for Placement brought to you by Talent Battle. In this video, we will discuss common difficulties faced by beginners during coding rounds. So without wasting any time, let us begin. These are the issues we will look at. I will explain each one of them one by one. So the first common difficulty faced by students is that they don't understand the problem statement itself. Reason behind this is that college programming assignments are restricted to one or two lines where what you have to do is directly given. For example, it will be directly asked to write a program to find prime numbers up to 100, or a program will be given like reverse a given string. But in coding rounds, question might be given in story format. So you also have to understand what exactly is expected from you. The problem structure is typically like this. First of all, a problem statement will be given. This problem statement can be given in a story-like format. It will be generally consisting of up to 5 to 10 lines. After that, input format will be given. That is what exact values you have to take as input. After that, output format will be given. That what exact values you have to print as an answer. Note that no precursor statements like the answer is and after that printing number is will be allowed as a right answer. You have to, if it is given that you have to print only a single integer, then you must print single integer only. No other extra lines, sentences will be allowed. After that, the next section is constraints. These constraints are for the input values that you will take above. Okay, after that, one sample example will be given, that is some sample inputs will be given, and for these inputs what output is expected in the above program that will be provided. Okay, so this sample example is very important, and if the question setters are really good people, then they will also provide you with the brief explanation for the above example. Note here that this explanation will be very short, and approach for the solution will not be discussed in this explanation. So generally, this is the problem structure for any question in a programming round. After understanding the problem structure, it is important to read the problem completely. Now, many students get overwhelmed by the length of the problem. As I told you earlier, the question can be quite big, but there is no necessity to assume that if a question is long, its solution will also be long. So don't get overwhelmed by the problem. And while reading the problem, focus on the crux part of the problem. As I told you earlier that a question will be given in a story-like format. So in that, focus on the sentences where the operations you have to provide on variables are given, or the conditions that answer are given. Focus on those sentences only. Rest of the part, you can just quickly glance through it. And the last point to look at is sample examples are your best friend. So it is quite often that even after reading the problem statement carefully, you do not quite understand the complete meaning of a problem. Alright, in that case, keep on reading the problem. Keep on reading input format, output format, constraints. But the biggest help will be example, that is for the given input, output. Why exactly this output is given? Try and understand that. It will help you to understand what is exactly expected from you in the above problem statement. If an explanation is provided, then it is well and good. It will help you to understand problem in more depth, but at least example will be given in each and every problem, and do focus on this example. Make sure that you understand this example completely. So this is all about understanding the problem statement. To summarize this answer, I can say, first of all, read the problem completely. After that, focus on the crux part of the problem. And last thing is understand the sample example really well. Okay, so once you do these three things, I don't think you will face any difficulty in understanding the problem statement. Next common difficulty faced by beginners during coding round is they cannot decide how to approach a particular problem. To tackle this problem, first point is know your company. This means that know about what kind of programming questions are generally asked by that company. Because if you have an idea about difficulty level of a coding problem, it becomes easy to approach it. For example, in TCS Ninja coding round, difficulty level of problem statement will be fairly easy. So while thinking about the solution, if it is getting too much complicated, you can say that your thought process is in the wrong direction and you should approach in different way. Next point is use pen and paper to manually solve given example. Forget about programming, just solve it on your own. When you write down an example on paper, you can visualize the question and solution much more clearly. And once you can solve it manually, you just have to translate that logic in programming syntax. Even if initially you have used very naive approach to manually solve it, you can modify your answer to better efficiency after thinking more on it. So I would say using pen and paper to solve a problem is quite essential. Next point to discuss is the time complexity. Now while talking about time complexity, I am not going to talk about its mathematical expressions or its mathematical derivations. Rather, I am giving the practical applications of time complexity. So first of all, we will look at one rule of thumb. Now whenever a coding problem is given, the expected time limit for that problem will also be given. For example, you have your solution for that problem. Must solve that problem within 1 second or must solve that problem within 2 seconds, something like that. Alright, so generally the modern computers nowadays can solve up to 10 raised to 8 or 10 raised to 9 operations per second. So this is 10 raised to 8, 10 raised to 9 operations per second. Now if the complexity of your program is n square and the value of n is 10 raised to 5. Okay, listen what I am saying. Complexity of your program is n square and the value of n in your case is 10 raised to 5. Then in that case, the overall operations your program will perform will be 10 raised to 10. And this 10 raised to 10 will definitely exceed the time limit, that is 10 raised to 8 or 10 raised to 9. So in such case, you know that you have to come up with the better approach than the n square time complexity. In the similar way, even if your complexity for the program is just n, big O of n, but the value of n in this case is suppose 10 raised to 12. Then also 10 raised to 12 is bigger than 10 raised to 9. So this approach will not work. You have to come up with better solution. Maybe suppose big O of log n. In that case, this solution will work. Big O of n will not work. So this is the rule of thumb. Keep in mind that this 10 raised to 8 or 10 raised to 9 operations per second, your program should not exceed this time limit. Now, I hope you know about these basics about time complexity, that suppose you are running a loop from say I is equal to 0 up to I is equal to n. You are running a single loop in your program, then in that case the time complexity of this program will be big O of n. In the similar way, if you are running two loops, that is first is I is equal to 0 up to I is equal to n, and within that loop, that is nested loop, is from j is equal to 0 up to j is equal to n, then in that case this is two loops. A loop is nested within each other, so in that case the time complexity will be big O of n square. If there is third loop, suppose of k, which is nested, then the time complexity is big O of n cube. Now note here that this complexity increases if the loops are nested within each other. If our first loop is I is equal to 0 up to I is equal to n, and our second loop is j is equal to 0 up to j is equal to n, but these two loops are separate loops, that is after finishing this first loop, second loop is getting started, then in that case the time complexity is big O of n only, because no loops are nested within each other in this particular case. So that is why the time complexity will be big O of n, whereas if the loops are nested, the time complexity will be increased exponentially. And the next point is use fast input output techniques for printing and taking inputs. Now this is important. Object oriented languages like Java or Python, this is very significant. In programming languages such as C or C++, these things will not make such difference because anyway C and C++ are a pretty fast language. But in Java, if you are using outputs like system.out.println, Or suppose you are using scanner objects for taking input, then those operations are rather slow. Instead of that, if you can use print writer or buffered reader, those operations are fast and that will save you some time, which is important in time complexity. Next query, which a lot of students ask, is about remembering syntax in during the coding rounds. Now, one good thing for all the candidates is that questions are generally designed to test your problem-solving skills. They are not designed to test your memory power. Okay, so you need not remember a lot of syntax. You need not remember some syntax related to file handling or network programming or system programming. Basically, just the normal syntax such as if else, just normal input-output techniques. After that, loops and some rather, if I am forgetting something, some basic rules are only required, not some very complicated syntax are required to solve a problem in a coding round. I would recommend all of you to, rather than remembering the syntax, try to remember different kind of algorithms and different kind of techniques during for a coding round. As I have told in earlier videos also, that you can remember all the libraries and frameworks in different programming language which help you with the predefined data structures. For example, in C++ you have something called as standard template libraries. In Java you have your collections framework. So these kind of libraries and frameworks helps us to auto-generate the code for stack or queue or trees and many other such data structures. So you might not need to take efforts to remember syntax like if else or for loop, while loop or etc. But you should take a little bit effort to remember the syntax for using these predefined libraries. So that's all for this video. I hope you got to learn something from this video. If you face any other difficulty during a programming round, feel free to ask that question in comment section below. Moreover, to follow many such videos related to programming or placement, please subscribe to our YouTube channel as we will be posting regular updates here.